focus on a banking story. Now, the NCLAT had dictated that no bank can declare an entity under resolution process as an NPA without its nod. So let's take a look at the bank's treatment to the account in the third quarter. Abhishek, I guess the account which is under resolution right now and the one they're referring to is IL&FS. So what impact does it have on the banks?
Exactly, Reema, all the accounts are under resolution process barring the holding company. So NCLT has mentioned is that no bank can actually declare any of the entities under resolution of IL&FS as an NPA without its prior approval. So, NCLT says that they do not want IL&FS entities to become an NPAs, and this can actually, if you treat it as NPA, it hinders the revival process. So, IL&FS, let's have a look, how IL&FS account was treated across banks in Q3. So, it has been retained as a standard account by IndusInd Bank and L&T Finance. Remember that IndusInd Bank has close to 3,000 crore of exposure to IL&FS across its holding company and the various group entities, while L&T Finance has an exposure of close to 1,800 crores. Let's look at the impact that some of the banks had in the Q3 earnings. So Yes Bank had actually classified IL&FS as an NPA. The overall exposure is at 2,530 crore, but the NPA classification was up to 1,952 crores. You look at Syndicate Bank. They did mention to us, that they had made a provision on 80% of their exposure, and that was to 1,600 crore of provisions made in Q3, which means that their exposure was at 2,000 crore. Canara Bank had also classified IL&FS as an NPA, so which was around 1,700 crores. The other banks which actually had a high provisions in Q3 on account of classifying IL&FS as an NPA is Allahabad Bank, Bank of Baroda and Vijaya Bank. We have other banks also, but the impact is not as significant as the top six that we mentioned: Yes Bank, Syndicate, Canara, Allahabad, Bank of Baroda, and Vijaya Bank. Back to you.
Okay, all right. Thanks so much for that, Abhishek. Well, let's move on then. Let's get you a trade on the Nifty then. We have Ashwini Gujral and Prakash Gaba who join us at this point of time with the Nifty holding at around 10,820. Ashwini, coming across to you first. What's the trade at these levels? And if someone had a long position and has had a decent run in the last few days, I think the last four trading sessions were up nearly around 200 points. At what level should they be keeping their stop loss at?
Well, if you've been hanging on for last couple of days when we've been sideways, I think the market is close to a breakout, and my sense is you will get short covering both on Nifty and Bank Nifty, and possibly a rally going into the close. So now the market is ready for a fresh breakout, because we need to do the upper end of the range, which is about 10,950, 11,000. Having said that, ICICI Bank is a buy with a stop of 52, target of 366. DB's Lab is a buy with a stop of 1585, target of 1640. And Balram Puccini is a buy with a stop of 126, target of 138.
Ashwini, what's happening in HDFC Limited?
Nothing significant.
No, it's been falling for the last few days. So what is the chart telling you?
See, before that it went up from 1650 to 2000, just a minor correction. We are not in any sort of bull market, so stocks will not go up daily. Once a certain set of stocks move higher, they get into a correction, and another set of stocks they move higher. Today pharma, IT is higher, banks are kind of little choppy. But overall, other banks are higher, and this sort of decline to the 200-day moving average on HDFC or any other bank should be bought into.
Okay, all right. We have Prakash Gaba with us as well in the studio. Hi, Prakash. What's your trade on the Nifty right now?
Nifty so far looks okay to me. I mean, we've seen a good up move on Thursday and Friday, and that range was there, and the range has been taken out today. And we did see a support there coming closer to that range. So far, it looks good to me. The next technical targets on the Nifty is 10,851. I think it's going there. And if it stays beyond that as well, then I have a target of 10,914. So in the days to come, still looks okay to me. Only thing is crucial support is 10,750. As long as that holds, we are fine. We might see dips. The dips would be buying opportunities. I have two stocks. both on the long side. Ashok Leland certainly looks like a buy here. I think give some time and space, is heading to levels closer to 86. Stop below 81 should be okay. And I also happy to like Dr. Reddy. Pharma is looking good to me. Dr. Reddy could climb to around 2,770 zones. Stop below 2,650.
Ashwini, any disclosures?
We have long positions on Nifty and Divisla.
And Prakash?
No disclosure.
All right. Thank you very much for joining in. So the Nifty is now at the 10,820, which is close to that 50-day moving average. We will slip into a very short break, but on the other side, we get that promised discussion going on the real estate stock. Is it a big boost to the sector after the GST rate on premium housing and affordable housing was cut by the GST Council over the weekend? More details with Ghulam Zia, the Executive Director of Knight Frank.